My name is Tanya David. I'm a graduate student here at Norfolk State University. We are going to be showing how to actually run a sample on NMR, which is nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. And we are actually going to be using this instrument right here, our NMR machine, which is about 300 megahertz, which gives you really good resolution, and we also have a very strong magnet in it. NMR helps in determining the structure of a molecule based on the response of the nuclei with a non-zero spin. That response is determined by the environment that the nuclei experience within the molecule. This here is an NMR tube. This is what you use to prepare your samples. And we're going to use hexanol as our sample today. And you use about 5 milligrams. For liquids, it's a little bit easier. You don't really have to weigh it. You can use just a small amount. And going down, you can see the liquid moving down. Whenever you do NMRs, you use deuterated solvents. Normally we use deuterated chloroform, but sometimes if your sample is not soluble in chloroform, you can use D2O or DMSO deuterated solvents. So we put about 1/2 mL, maybe a little bit more, about 1 mL in there in the sample. And then you quickly cap your sample with an NMR cover. You can give it a little quick shake. Try not to get it into the cap so that you get all the sample that came down on the sides. Computers for NMR, you'll have some type of icon which you can click, and this is what it looks like for Brucker icon NMR, and you usually pick routine spectroscopy. This is the screen that normally will come up. You'll go to insert new sample, you click on it, and you wait to hear the air in the NMR machine, and then you can place your sample in it. Well, after you prepare your sample, this is the sample holder that you put it in. You use this to measure your level of solvent. Make sure that this line splits your sample. You put it in, and then you allow it to drop. After you insert your sample, then you'll click OK, and your sample will drop down into the chamber. Here you have file name. We're just going to pick hexanol for our sample name. Press Enter, then press OK. Set solvent and experiment. Since we use deuterated chloroform, you click deuterated chloroform. The experiment, we are going to do a proton NMR. And we use proton 8. You can also use proton for 16 scans, or we're going to do 8 scans. And then we press start. If you want to just see what you have quickly, you can allow the computer to go ahead and do everything automatically, shim it, lock the sample, and then give you your readout. Under X-Win NMR version, this is actually the spectrum that we have for hexanol. And this is allowing the computer to actually run the scan by itself. Now we're actually going to try do it manually, shim and lock the machine manually, which actually gives you a better resolution. So we're going to go to this button down here, icon NMR routine. We will go to continue right here in the commands. Since we already have a sample in there, we're going to say use same and continue. Same sample. So they already set the chloroform. We already know that we have deuterated chloroform, so that's already set. Under set experiments right here, we're going to go ahead and do proton NMR again, proton 8. Gonna click OK under commands. Then we're gonna go to start. After start, we're gonna press stop. And it's gonna say, do you really want to stop all acquisition processes? You press yes. We're going to go to X-Win NMR, click on it. We're going to go up to Windows, And we're going to go down to BSMS panel, and we're going to click on that. That pulls up this bar here. We're going to open up our lock, our grid lock. And within the BSMS display, we're going to press on lock right here. Moving this screen over. If your lock is already on, if it's highlighted, you click it again to turn it off. So then that makes your lock screen, your grid, look like this. Now what we're paying attention is to these two very large peaks right here. They're extremely too large. So we're gonna go to lock gain under the lock panel, click on that. And we're going to adjust the height of those. So we're going to bring them down just a bit by clicking into this scroll bar. You kind of play with it back and forth to see which one will give you, bring it down to a level where you can actually see the peaks. Okay, so that's just about as good as we're going to get. Then you go to field on the lock panel. And once again, now you want to align these two peaks in this center, along this center axis. What we're trying to align right now is the radio frequency radiation that it will actually irradiate the nuclei within your samples. You're fine-tuning the radio frequency to the optimum resonance absorption frequency of your nuclei. This is what we're doing. So once again, you click in the scroll bar to adjust it. Now, if they disappear altogether, then you can actually click where it says actual, and you can actually fill in the numbers. So right now we're at 5087. We can adjust it to 5080 and see how our peaks move on our lock grid. So move just a little too much so we can go back and readjust. Then you go to lock phase because now we need these two peaks to be at the same level. And once again, you click in your scroll bar, you click back and forth until they adjust, until they're the same height. So then you have the max frequency for this particular sample for the nuclei. Now they're at pretty much the same height, you can actually press lock now on the lock panel, and you've locked that frequency in. And this is the frequency you'll irradiate your sample at. So you can actually close out the lock panel now, and now we're going to shim it. Shimming is actually aligning your magnets. So there's one large magnet and then smaller magnets within the NMR machine. What you're doing with when you're shimming, you're aligning the smaller magnets with the larger magnet to give you a uniform magnetic field. So what you really only want to actually fix the Z and Z squared axis. Altering the other parameters can actually mess up the machine, and you have to readjust it. So once again, you click your Z, and then you go down here to the scroll bar, and you click back and forth. So let's click in one direction, and you'll actually see your line moving down. So if it's moving down like this, as you see here, you do not want that. That's actually reducing your magnets to not the optimum position. You want them to go as high as they can go on the grid. So then you go in the opposite direction. You keep clicking until they can't go any higher. When you get good at this, this whole process takes about 2 minutes. Now, as you can see, this is going extremely too high up on our grid. So what you can do is go back to shim panel, go to lock gain, and you go down to your scroll bar and you move this down to about less than half of the screen. And then you go back to your Z axis, and now you go back and you try to optimize. See how high you can get the signal. Okay, let's go to Z squared now. And you do the same thing with Z squared. You just keep clicking back and forth to see if you can get it to go any higher. Once you've reached to the highest peak, then you can actually stop. So right now I think we've reached its maximum. So now you can close out all of your boxes. You go back down here to icon NMR. You go to continue. Use same and continue. Under routine flowchart, you already still have your deuterated solvent clicked in, so you go to set experiment. You set your proton 8, press OK, and then press start. And as you can see, normally if the computer does it on its own, it goes through all of these acquisitions. But since we have already locked and shimmed our sample, it skipped directly to aligning the nuclei within your sample. In order to see your field induction decay, you can actually go under commands, go to view, and press FID. And this is the signal that you see when your excited nuclei are relaxing back down to the ground level. And this is what the signal that it gives you before it goes through the Fourier transform and then gives you actually nice spectrum. Now, as you can see the difference from before, now your peaks are a lot sharper. The resolution is much better when you manually shim the sample instead of allowing the computer to do it. So if you want a nice, neat, clean spectrum, it's always better to manually shim the machine. This is the x-axis is in parts per million, records your chemical shift, and the y-axis, we understand it to be intensity, the intensity of your absorption peaks. The peak here at zero and at approximately 7.3, this is your TMS and your chloroform. Within your deuterated solvent, like chloroform, you have a little bit of TMS, tetramethylsilane, as a reference. So if you don't have these reference peaks, it will actually be hard to see the other peaks in your spectrum. This peak here represents your methyl group at the end of your hexanol, which hexanol has 6 carbons and 14 hydrogens. One hydrogen actually belongs to your alcohol, your OH group. So this is your methyl group. This larger peak represents the middle protons on your adjacent carbons, and then this one is shifted a little bit because it's one carbon away from your OH group. So this is actually represents the proton that's right next to your OH group. Once the sample is finished and you are finished with everything, you go to icon NMR routine, you go to continue, and you can click eject and terminate. And you wait to hear the air pushing your sample up, which is right there. Take your sample out, press enter, and you are finished.